हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल डेंटिस्ट्री मेड इजी। द टॉपिक फॉर टुडे इज मैंडिबुलर नर्व फ्रॉम ट्राइजेमिनल नर्व। सो इट इज़ अ ब्रांच ऑफ अ ट्राइजेमिनल नर्व। सो बेसिकली आई एम फोकसिंग मोर ऑन द मैंडिबुलर नर्व। सो योर ट्राइजेमिनल नर्व, सो आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द ट्राइजेमिनल नर्व इन शॉर्ट। सो ट्राइजेमिनल नर्व, इट इज़ द लार्जेस्ट क्रेनियल नर्व, दैट इज़ योर फिफ्थ क्रेनियल नर्व। इट कंटेन्स बोथ मोटर एंड सेंसरी फाइबर्स। सो सेंसरी फाइबर्स आर दोज which helps in the sensations, and motor are the ones that supplies the muscles. Now it is attached to the pons. So it is attached to the lateral part of your pons. This trigeminal nerve is attached to the lateral part of the pons by its two roots, that is your sensory and motor. And these roots, they are entering the middle cranial fossa. So starting off with the sensory one. So this sensory, they arise from the semilunar ganglia. And they enter the brain stem through the side of the pons. The motor one is originated in the motor nucleus, which is located in the upper area of the pons, and your trigeminal nerve is mostly motor type of nerve, though it has sensory part too, but it is chiefly motor, and hence it is known as, and it also supplies, as it is mainly supplying the muscles of mastication, hence it is known as masticator nerve. So this is in short about your trigeminal nerve, how it gets originated. So this trigeminal nerve is, now it has three branches, that is, the first one is ophthalmic, second is maxillary, and third one is mandibular. Ophthalmic is known as V1, as it is the first branch. V2 is your maxillary, and V3 is the mandibular nerve. And your trigeminal nerve is known as trigeminal, as it has these three branches. Tri is three. So hence it got the name trigeminal nerve. So starting off with the main topic, that is the mandibular nerve. So it is the third branch of your trigeminal nerve. Now I'm going to explain mandibular nerve, like completely the course, distribution and everything about it. Mandibular nerve, it is the largest of the three divisions of your trigeminal nerve. It has both sensory and the motor fibers. It is the nerve of first brachial arch, and it supplies all the structures that are derived from that brachial arch. So it has this large sensory and small motor fibers. This large sensory, they are the peripheral extension of unipolar cells that are located in the semilunar ganglion. So this large sensory is located in semilunar ganglion. And this small motor fibers, they are derived from motor cells, which is located in medulla oblongata. So this is like the starting of it, how you need to write your answers as. So starting off with, it has this one large sensory fiber and small motor fibers. So your sensory fibers, they are distributed, like what all it supplies in depth, like in general, what all it supplies is, it is distributed to dura, skin, mucous membrane of the chin, cheek, lower lip, then external ear, then it is supplied to the parotid gland, then temporomandibular articulation, scalp, lower teeth, and the anterior two-third of the tongue. So this is the distribution of the sensory fiber. The motor fiber, it supplies muscles of mastication, like all the muscles of mastication, those four muscles of mastication it supplies to, then tensor villi palatini, tensor tympani, and it also supplies to mylohyoid and anterior belly of digastric. So this is the motor fiber where all it supplies to in depth. Now which branch of your mandibular supplies to what, I'm going to explain that in depth now. So these are like, they were two different fibers. So they pass through foramen ovale and they are united. So they form a main trunk, and now your mandibular is divided again into two types. So these are like branches from undivided nerve. So as it forms a main trunk, then again it gets divided into two, that is the branches from your divided nerve, that is your anterior branch and the posterior branch. So first it was divided, then as it passed from foramen ovale, it gets united as a main trunk, and then again it gets divided into anterior and posterior. So your branches from undivided nerves, so it supplies to the nervous spinosus, that is it supplies to the dura mater of the middle cranial fossa, and the next one is the nerve to the internal pterygoid. So it supplies to your pterygoid muscle, and it also supplies to tensor villi palatini and tensor tympani muscles. So this are like distribution of your undivided nerve. So starting off with the divided nerve, so anterior part of it is smaller one and the posterior is a larger one. So this anterior, it has motor and sensory fibers. So you have to remember this ratio 3:1. So there are three muscle fibers and one sensory. So the three muscle fibers, like the motor fibers, are first it supplies to the external pterygoid, the next one it supplies to the masseter and temporalis. So temporal, that is again temporal is divided into two, anterior and posterior deep. And the last sensory part is your long buccal. Now you have to remember this word long buccal. You can't just write buccal because you can confuse it with the facial nerve as it has that branch buccal. So you have to write long buccal when you are writing it for a mandibular nerve. So your long buccal, now other three are the muscles. So it supplies the muscle with that name. So these are the muscles of mastication. The long buccal, it supplies to the buccal gingiva of the mandibular molars and to the mucosa of the cheeks. So when you're giving like a INA, when you're extracting a mandibular tooth, so at that time mandibular molar, at that time even you're giving a long buccal, but when you're like extracting canines or premolars, at that time you don't give a long buccal anesthesia. Now the next part is the posterior, so it is a larger one and it is mainly sensory. It is again divided into three branches, that is your auriculotemporal, lingual and infraalveolar. This auriculotemporal is again divided into five branches, that is parotid, articular, auricular, metal and terminal. So you can remember it like there's a link. So there is parotid, then it follows that link, then there is this articulation, the TMJ articular, and then you follow that ear. So it is like a link between it. Then the lingual one is the 2/3 of the tongue and the lingual part of your old teeth. So it's like when you are giving a mandibular anesthesia, at that time you will find a subjective sign as numbness of the anterior 2/3 of the tongue. So last is moving on towards the infraalveolar nerve. Now it is the largest branch of the posterior branch. On the medial side of the ramus in the pterygomandibular space, it enters the mandibular foramen. So the pterygomandibular space is like, as you know, it is a landmark when you're giving infraalveolar nerve block. So it supplies all the lower teeth and the periodontal membrane. So when you're removing any mandibular teeth, like when you're extracting, you need to give INA block, nerve block. So it enters the mandibular foramen and then it follows and it reaches this mental foramen. When it passes through the mental foramen, it gives this two terminal branches, that is this mental nerve and incisive nerve. Incisive nerve, it supplies to the cuspids and the incisors. Cuspids are the canines and incisors, it supplies all these mandibular incisors and cuspids. Then the mental nerve, it supplies to the skin of the chin and the skin and the mucous membrane of the lower lip. So this is again a subjective sign. There is a numbness of the lower lip when you're giving anesthesia, that is this INA nerve block. So it enters, so basically it's like before it enters, the mandibular foramen, it gives one more branch, that is, it gives the branch of myelohyoid. The myelohyoid branch, it supplies to the myelohyoid muscles and the anterior belly of digastric, and then it enters the mandibular foramen. So this is like whole course of your mandibular nerve. Now I'm going to show you like how you can draw a diagram in your exams within 5 minutes for this particular, if you get an answer for the mandibular nerve. So what you can do is, first you can draw a mandible, and then you can draw the myelohyoid muscle and the anterior belly of digastric. Then it is like you can draw hyoid bone over here. As it, you know, the myelohyoid muscle is from mandible to the hyoid bone, and it is related to the deglutition. So you can draw these muscles, like you can show all the structures which it is supplying to. So first is, I have showed this myelohyoid and anterior belly of digastric. Then you can draw tongue. So you're drawing this tongue. After that, you're drawing the other muscles, that is your styloglossus and genioglossus. So basically 5 to 7 minutes to draw. So this was the diagram that I used to draw in my exams, like if I get this answer. Now there are many diagrams that you can like find at various places, but like it's on you which diagram you need to draw. So this one was the one that I used to draw. After that, I used to draw all the teeth, the mandibular teeth, and then like I used to just complete it, like all the roots and everything. And after that, I used to just draw the course of the mandibular nerve, what all it is supplying to. So it, as it supplies to the anterior tooth of the tongue, etc. So this was the like a gist of the diagram. So this is like the basic structure of it, and then you just need to draw the distribution of your mandibular nerve. So now I'll show you the diagram that I used to draw. So this is like the complete diagram of your mandibular nerve with all those anterior branches, posterior branches, and what all it is supplying to. So this is like the whole diagram that you need to draw for the mandibular nerve. So in short, it's like they have this sensory and motor root. They get united at the foramen ovale, and then again they are dividing into anterior and posterior branches. So that was it of this video. I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you so much.